Shimmer's my thing, as many of you know. I don't think that comes as a huge surprise. In today's 5 Minutes of Fun video, I'm working with the 6 new colors of Cosmic Shimmer Airless Pearlescent Misters. This release features colors that are a bit bolder and really look awesome when used with stencils. Or for more fun, combine them with other sprays for a really different look. We're continuing the 20% off introductory sale, and you'll find links down below. This release includes Hello Sunshine, Jazz Blue, Kiwi Twist, Mademoiselle Pink, Purple Obsession, and Teal Harmony. In this group, the mica color mostly matches the spray color, but not always. For example, when you look at Jazz Blue, you can see that the mica in it is actually gold. In the Purple Obsession, the mica color in it tends to be more of a blue or bluey purple color. So that's going to vary according to the colors. Now, when I was spraying to make all of these swatches, and let's move all this stuff out of the way, there obviously was stuff left on my table when I was through. And so rather than wipe it up, because I had a little bit of time while I was playing, these are our white chipboard supersized ATCs. So rather than 2.5 by 3.5, these are 3 by 4. And you can see there's the gold in the Jazz Blue. So I was working with a stencil, and you'll see that afterward. I was working with a stencil, and I printed what was left, and I kind of mopped up what was on my table as I was going through that process. So you kind of get the 2-for-1 thing going here. Now, the thing to know, and I want to, there's 2 colors I want to grab. Here we go. All right, so I'm going to work with, well, I actually grabbed, I have Purple Obsession and I have Teal Harmony. And the reason I grabbed these is because they're going to look great when I mix them together, which is something that you can do. But before I get to that, let's talk a little bit about what makes these different. So the first thing is that this is an airless mister, and I'm going to take one of these tops off in a second. But before I do that, now you don't hear a mixing ball yet, but I'm going to keep shaking, and that mixing ball is going to come loose. It will come loose. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer than others. Now these were, there we go. These were standing up like this, which means everything dropped to the bottom. I learned this from Diane Reevely. If you lay your stuff on the side like this, the mica spreads over a larger area and it takes less time to get itself going. So you have to shake this really well. Now if I hold this, you can kind of see the shimmer that's in the liquid, and there's a limited space where you can do this. But when you see that and you can see that there's shimmer in the liquid, shake it a little bit more just to be sure. Because if, for example, you look here, you can see that the yellow, there's really no shimmer in there because it's all stuck on the bottom or on the side, depending on how I laid that down. So with that said, let's talk about the delivery system. So off comes the cap, and then because this is an airless mister, there is in fact no pickup tube in here. It's just this little device here. So something to, where I was going with that is that that means that you can hold this pretty much at any angle. It doesn't matter how you hold this when you spray. So now I'm going to take the Purple Obsession and spray it, or shake it rather, because I want to spray them both and demo how this works. But I also want to show you that you can make some custom blends by mixing your colors. So I can hear both of those mixing balls going. Let me grab, so this is a 6 by 9 smooth and sturdy white disc bound page. And what I'm going to do is grab a stencil. So this is one of Karen Tamar's 9 by 12 stencils. It's named Unchained Cells. Now the thing to know about this particular system, and I'm going to keep shaking while I talk, the thing to know about this system is that not only can it spray from any angle, but depending on how you press the sprayer, the Mr. Top, it's going to affect what comes out. What I have discovered is that the harder you press, and the more you press all the way until it stops, is the finer the mist that you're going to get. So for example, see how I've got a fine mist? But if I do this, you can see that I've got more like droplets. And so that's your opportunity to kind of control what comes out of the mister as you go along. Now obviously this accumulates and it gets bigger dots as there's more on there. But same kind of thing going on here. Let's go ahead and mix that, and then let's put some of the purple up here. Now I probably oversprayed, but such is the story of my life. I don't need perfect, I need some color and shimmer. Although I gotta tell you, that's not bad at all. So you can see, and I don't want to tip this too much, but you can see that now I've got this blend going on, and that mica will become far more evident once it is in fact dry. So this is what I did to create these. So it's just really a question of going along and picking up the color. I mean, you can wipe it up. Nothing says you have to use it this way, but the nice thing is you get, like I said, you get this kind of 2-for-1 thing going. So let me wipe this up and just get the rest of it out of the way, because there's all kinds of shimmery, colorful goodness on the other side of this stencil that I want to take advantage of. So if I grab, well, if I grab another of these 6x9 pages, and go ahead and flip it over, I can print what's left. And I'm going to grab a fresh piece of paper towel and just go ahead and press that. I'm just trying to keep my fingers clean for a second. Not that that ever lasts very long, but, you know, it's a faint hope, but it's one that I hold on to every now and then. And I like this because now I've got the complete opposite going on here. My background is colored, and the actual design itself, of course, is the part that now is whatever the color of the background was. In this case, it happened to be white. Now, something else that I like to do, and I'm just going to put this stencil over there and get it out of the way. Something else that I like to do, and I'm going to bring in Hello Sunshine and start shaking, is I like to mix colors. I like to mix things like Distress Oxide sprays with mica powder, or excuse me, mica shimmer sprays like this, because I think it creates a really interesting look. You have all the things that happen, the oxidization and that pigment that is in the oxide sprays, and then you get the dye spray in here, which kind of thins things out, and then the mica. So this is one of kind of my favorite things to do. So I'm just going to take a second and give this a shake. And I'm going to work on, what am I going to work on this time? So this is a number 12 watercolor disc bound tag. The thing that I like with this is that I can start to make all kinds of custom blends and all kinds of color combinations, and normally I'll set myself up and I'll do a whole bunch of these at a time. All right, so that's probably enough of that. Now, was that shaken enough? Probably not quite. So this is what I call my dip and dab technique, and of course I've got a sprayer that doesn't want to work here. So we'll ignore that, and I'm going to bring in, this is Seedless Preserves, I'm going to bring that in instead. So I'm going to put some of each of these colors out. So I have Seedless Preserves, actually this is not what I wanted. Here's Spiced Marmalade, here's Rusty Hinge. We'll use this, and then I'm going to grab the Scattered Straw. Give that a shake. So this is a variation on Tim Holtz's Distress Wrinkle Free technique. I call it dip and dab because that's kind of what I do, is dip and dab. Make sure we've got our color up and moving here. Now I'm going to go pretty heavy with, because I want more mica. You, of course, can do whatever you want. All right, so dip and dab, dip and dab. That's really all this is. Now, pretty. I like that color combination. Now, what I would ordinarily do to preserve all of this in the center is I would take this to one side and dry it, and then I would come back and do the same thing again to get another layer of color on there. But since I don't have time to dry, this is of course supposed to be 5 minutes, and I can promise you it's probably going to run longer than that because there's too much good stuff to say about this. But this is the process, and then you use this up, and I have found that if I stand here and I kind of assembly line this, I can get tons of things done, backgrounds done all at once, which then leaves me time to come back and devote myself to adding other layers and then eventually focal images. All right, so one last thing. Once you have color on like that, and again, I'm just going to kind of wipe this up. That's really never enough for me. So here's one that's already dry. This is one of our 6x12 ring-bound journal pages. This is white, smooth, and sturdy. And I'm going to grab another of Karen's stencils. This one is named, I think this one is named Tribal Mandala. So I'm going to focus the center at kind of, let's do it right here. And I'm going to come back to Hello Sunshine because I think the yellow works with this. Actually, you know what? I take that back. Let's grab the Purple Obsession again because I like the purple with the Seedless Preserves. So I'm just going to give this a shake. In some place here, there it is. All right, I'm going to show you this in 1 second. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to apply this pretty heavily on this side. And there you can see the pattern. And then I'm going to go ahead and print this up here. Again, with a fresh piece of paper towel. I just want to press this down so that that liquid comes in contact with the background. And how cool is that? So let's get rid of this for a second. You can see I've got the pattern here, and then I've got the opposite of it printed up here. So it creates this kind of interesting look. And this background, the shimmer on this was Hello Sunshine. I can see the yellow in it. And with that said, this is something that I did that's pretty similar, where I sprayed through the stencil over here, and then I printed it over here. So, you know, these are the... Good grief, I've knocked them over about 10 times today. These are the 6 new colors of Cosmic Shimmer Airless Misters. Really nice colors, fun shimmer, and a very different delivery method.